it's your girl T. Graye. Welcome to the Love Below. You guys, you know I stay excited at all times, and today isn't any different. I am sitting with Mr. Michael Colyar.
It's my honor.
Hi, Michael.
Hello. It's a pleasure to be on this broadcast. You're talking about all the great comedians that you work with, DC Curry and Rodney Perry and all them. Heck yeah.
And let me tell you something. Ain't none of them got anything on you.
Well, tell the truth and shame the devil. Yeah. So how do we go? You got a list of questions for me?
I got plenty.
All right,
because you are, first of all, one of the best comedians.
God bless you.
I appreciate your delivery is amazing.
Thank you.
And when I see you, you guys, I get so excited when the Dej Love comes on because you hit your
Thank you, Dej Love.
Yes, I absolutely love it.
Thank you.
With being just a seasoned man in general, I'm sure you've learned a lot about sex along the way. What would be your best piece of sex advice?
Strap up.
Amen.
That's the best advice I can give. Strap up. I would say try not to be too loose and free willy out there. You know, it's really funny that you would ask that because, you know, AIDS is still real.
Yes, it is.
And STDs and STIs are still real. And it's easy to get caught up out here. You know, you're in the entertainment game and, you know, lovely people are excited about your performance. Mm-hmm. So they may be quicker to say yes, but maybe you might not want to be as quick to say yes. So if you're going to be out here doing a damn thing, if you're going to be wielding that tool, wrap it up. That's all I can say about that. But of course, ain't nobody gonna tell you what to do if you're a single person, you know, a single man out here, you know, gonna hang out, he's gonna do his thing, you know. If you out here and you ain't single, you better double strap up. Make sure ain't no cameras around.
Ain't no cameras around.
I did not say that.
That's exactly what you said.
Yeah, my only advice ever though about sex is really just be careful, be safe. That's the only thing. Because you don't know, and if you make love to somebody and you're not, strapped up, you're not protected, then you're not just making love to that person. You're making love to every person who made love to that person.
Yeah.
So that person might come off as looking really fresh and clean and everything, but you don't know who she was with last Saturday, and if she's willing to do it with you without one, then she's probably willing to do it with somebody before you without one, so you just, you don't want to take a chance, you know. That's why the whole dating scene is rough now. You can, like me, I won't even drink behind nobody no more. You know, I won't give mouth to mouth resuscitation unless I'm already fucking you. It ain't gonna happen. You be hold up, I go get somebody. You hold up right there, I'll be back.
I feel brief like that about a couple of my exes.
Yeah, you can't do it. You can't do it.
So on stage, mm-hmm. you speak a lot about your lady,
my queen. Yes,
can't wait Ms. to meet her one day.
Yeah, you
and you talk a lot about how she's your friend, which I feel like is very, very important.
She's my friend.
How big does that play in your sexual relationship with her being your friend and not just your lady?
I think it's everything, because I think any successful relationship is about communication. You know, so it's about communication and relationship. And if you have a friend, then you can communicate easier. Because the closer you are as friends, what is it you can't talk about?
Exactly.
You can talk about anything, even if you don't agree with each other. You can talk about your feelings about a particular thing and hash it out. You know what I'm saying? If you're not friends, then you're always on the guard, being careful what you say and quick to snap if the other person didn't say the thing the way you felt like they should say it to you. But when you're friends, you don't really have to go through all that old bullshit because you already know each other, you know? So I think friends play an enormous part in a successful relationship. And that's not just romantic, but any relationship. You know, it's funny when you talk about business relationships. All these white folks, especially used to just be the doctors and dentists and shit, all of them are off work on Wednesday because they had the golf course.
Yeah.
You know, and so black folks, I mean, especially pre-Tiger Woods, I really want to say even earlier, we weren't as interested in golf as we are now, because I don't think we understood the social ramifications of it. You know, like if I want to be in business with you, I could have you have dinner with me, then right. I could talk to you.
Right.
Or the next level is I could take you to my private club.
Right.
Now, we're not just having dinner, but people are falling over you and with service and whining and dining. Mm-hmm. You're pushing carts over. So you're taking that experience and making a bigger thing.
Yes.
Or I can go play golf with you. Mm-hmm. Now I'm with you for 4 hours. Just me and you. Out in all this beautiful green, right. Hitting the ball, talking shit. After a while, you're going to run out of business stuff. Mm-hmm. So now you have to talk about each other and yes. your family. And how are your kids? And what are your kids doing?
Right.
So now you're establishing relationship.
Yes,
and people like to spend money with people they know, and especially with people they like. So the friendship aspect is so important, you know? And if you're trying to be in a sexual relationship, once again, communications. Top
very
thing.
Right.
They'll make people very know important. Where you're coming from and to make them comfortable with you.
Right.
It's everything.
So what's most important about sex to you?
Coming.
Amen.
I don't even have to be there in a long time. Now, if I can come and get back to my damn movie, if I can just get that damn remote control. You know, it's so funny, Carla. I used to use Halle Berry, who I met many times, is a very nice lady. And I love her. You know, but we talk about communication and relationships.
Mm-hmm.
And she was hooked up with four amazing professional gentlemen who all were very successful.
Yes.
And they all slapped the shit out of her.
Yes.
Now, I don't know what she said. I don't know what happened. And the common denominator in all those relationships is her. So what did she say? And people say, well... And, you know, it's just men, because men don't cheat
no matter
what. And that's not true.
Yeah, that's
and
not
the proof I tell you all the time is you don't believe it, then when your man get ready to go out, here's the experiment. Before he go out, say, baby, before you go, though, let me fix your shower. Run him a shower. While he's in the shower, you go and make sure the bed is perfect. Put on your hottest negligee. You don't want to put on, you want to be butt naked.
Butt
naked is the end of the game.
Right,
you give him something to work at. Yeah. Mm-hmm. You want to have his favorite wine, sit him a glass while he's in there, roll him one of them fat, you know, cigarettes without the writing on the side.
Amen.
Burn a little incense, put your favorite scent on, and when he's about to leave, put on his clothes. When he come in that room and see you laying across that bed, let me tell you something. When he come in, before he go out, fuck it. And when I fuck him, I mean fuck him where his feet have to grab the bottom of the bed, shake motherfucking bed like that. See if that motherfucker goes somewhere.
No,
he ain't going to sleep. Let me tell you something.
Like,
brother,
you're taking a nap.
I'm telling you not. If we can get some coochie and a remote control, we don't need shit else. So when they say, oh, no, men cheat no matter what, no. When you're happy, you don't go nowhere else. Because our ultimate goal is to reach the utopia, which is happy. If we already have happy, we ain't going happy. If we go... That's because happy was not experienced at that spot. Something close to it
right.
might have been. Like, right. in the Hebrew faith, there's a thing called Beshirta. Like, my woman is my Beshirta.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm being a man, I'm her Beshirt.
Mm-hmm.
And that means your perfect half. In the book of Talmud, which is one of the books that the Hebrews go by, which is like their Bible, but it's really their book of rules. They have 112, I think, rules and lessons that they have to know. And... in it, it says that God created man as two perfect halves. When you find your perfect half, then you become whole, and your heart sings a royal song, and you never have to look again. That's your Beshirta, or your Beshir. Now, people say, well, if that's true, why are there so many divorces? Well, they didn't find your Beshirta.
Right, right.
They found someone who was close, and they mm-hmm. settled.
And they did.
You know?
And
so then they find out down a couple of years later that that's not what they want to spend the rest of their life doing, is being with that person. So you can find your Beshirta. Your Beshirta's out there, but it takes a little work. It takes a little communication. It takes a little time. But if it's just about fucking, well, for me, I love sex. I love the oral part of it is so important. The kissing, the hugging, the taking the time, the caressing.
Right.
You know, oils are really nice.
Mm-hmm.
Scents, what you smell is really, really important.
Good.
Like that woman out there hugging five times to get a picture, taking 8 times. She said, well, you still smell good. And I mean, what do you mean still? Like, you mean from 2 minutes ago when you said that?
Trying to rub it off.
She was just all on, and then she pushed her titty up against me. Feel that left titty, you know, and you know. Man,
did you feel the left titty?
I don't want to break her heart or nothing. I don't want to hurt her feeling. The titty was right there. I didn't feel it with my hand. Just sort of leaned against the titty. Look, just a little lean like that. But you. I want all of that. I want sweet talk.
Right.
You know,
you
because you need to make me come in my mind.
Yes.
Before I come out
And that's
my
major
scepter.
That's major. Not a lot of men speak to that about the mental side of sex with them. A lot of men, you talk about it, laugh about it, whatever, and it's all about the nut. But it's very, very mental for men as well, especially if you're into it.
I want to make love, though. You know, so I don't. Though I want to fuck too. Don't get me wrong.
Yes, you do.
And it's different.
Do.
You know, sometimes you be making love and shit gets so good to turn into fucking. You know, I'm talking about shit splashing and everything. But essentially, I want to make love.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
If you're not into it mentally, really, then you're just fucking. And it comes to a point where the other person's just the object to help get you off. Mm-hmm. You can do that with your hand. I'm very friendly with my hand.
Right.
Me and my hand have spent many wonderful hours together.
Well, kudos to your hand.
Oh, I can change hands. Mystery. But if I'm with a woman, I really want the love aspect. I want to be caressed. I want you to talk. And I love women who know how to tease you, play games with you, you know. You know, that makes it exciting. That makes it exciting. That's
so
the whole game.
First, we need to take you golfing on the Wednesday.
Hey! Hey! You play with my balls anytime.
And then have the talk. The discussion to pull you in.
Yeah.
And
then
rape you.
There it is. You can drop the golf. We can hold up on them 4 hours. Let's get to the next segment. Yeah.
But one thing that you had mentioned when you were talking about Halle Berry puts me in mind of the fact that
I love Halle Berry.
Subconsciously, we send out certain signals, you guys, to attract certain kinds of people. So even when you're in those modes of, say, you may see that you're attracting the wrong type of person, there is something inside of you that still sends out those signals. And it's unfortunate, but learning to conquer those signals, even in sex, is very, very important. You could be subconsciously attracting the wrong type of sexual partner.
True.
And letting that wrong kind of negative spirit into your system. Being able to overcome that, being able to be bigger than that, being able to then have a deeper level of intimacy and not just be fucking all the time, it's important. And it's important. I'm not taking nothing away from it. Lord knows T. Gray likes to fuck. But
thank
I'm saying,
you. Michael Cotty too.
Being able to get to a point where you have true intimacy, that's major. A lot of people have never experienced that. A lot of people will only be fucking. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, some people are not going to take a chance with their heart like that. They're not going to put their heart out there like that. They're not going to go in that deep because so many people have been hurt so many times that they've built an emotional wall around themselves. Mm-hmm. So that level is not coming into the game. The game for them is going to be called satisfaction.
Yes.
Can I just have a nice soothing night and just come? Let me have a couple drinks, talk to you, listen to a little music, dance, let you grind. Whatever happened to fucking grinding? Grinding was so
wonderful. Thing.
Now you don't want a motherfucker to touch you on a dance floor. Get the fuck over there, you know.
But they don't want him to touch him, but they'll go home and sleep with him.
Yes, which takes it to fucking instead of making love.
Yeah.
Because you've eliminated the element of being a friend, of the communication aspect of it. Mm-hmm. You have notice each other and realize there's a sexual attraction there, and you go, okay, good, let me get it. You better get you some. So you go on and get you some, and then later you're like, it was really nice knowing you, but you know what? I got some other shit I gotta do.
Right.
You know? Right. So, you know, but at the end of the game, we're all pretty much the same. We're all flawed human beings who are trying to find that thing that makes us happy, that brings us joy, that doesn't break our heart, doesn't hurt our feelings. You know, that could accept us and understand us for who we are. And that goes for men and women. Who we are and how we are. Because ain't no perfect motherfuckers. We all got something wrong, a tick or some shit. That, you know, attitude, too much ego. We always got some shit that keeps us from being perfect because that's the way of the universe. There aren't any perfect human beings. If you find a perfect motherfucker, you should stab him in the throat with a plastic fork and run your ass off because he's not a human. He's some other shit, you know.
Yeah.
There's even a book called If You Meet the Buddha on the Road, Kill Him. And that book, that title really is saying you ain't gonna meet the Buddha. You don't meet Jesus Christ. You're not gonna be walking down Crenshaw and meet Jesus. I do a joke about it. I was on Crenshaw one day, and I saw Jesus Christ. And I was blown away, and he came up to this puddle. And I'm like, God, fuck, what's he gonna do? And he walked around. But you're not gonna meet Jesus. You're not gonna. And anyway, Jesus Christ was not a Christian. Buddha was not a Buddhist. These were enlightened men.
Right.
So it's rare that we'll meet an enlightened person like that, especially after he's moved into the Godhead. You're not going to meet that person. That's why I said, if you meet somebody that's perfect, something's very wrong with them.
Yeah.
So be leery. You know, and that's not the sin of making out that there ain't no perfect people, but it ain't.
It ain't.
Fuck it. Ain't no perfect people. We're all flawed human beings, and all we can try to do is our best. Because practice doesn't make us perfect. Practice just makes us better. Jesus wasn't perfect. You know, Jesus spent a little time with Mary Magdalene. You know, she did on the side. No, you know, and Jesus, he could turn wine into water, walk on water. But you still see what they did to him. Mm-hmm. So, we ain't shooting for perfection. We're just shooting for better. Like, I don't need to be better than Eddie Murphy or Richard Pryor. I just need to be better than me.
Amen.
That's why I'm in competition with nobody but me. If I could just be, if I'm a better Michael Collier tomorrow, then I've done something, you know. So, that's all the time I got for y'all. So, what else was there? You got any burning questions you need to ask me before I run out of here? Because I got people waiting for me and I don't want to be rude.
No, I don't have anything else, Bernie.
It was a pleasure to have this conversation.
Would
you
like to tell people about your tour? You want to tell
them
about
I'm Michael Collier. My social media is Instagram is Michael, and it's H-A-E-L. A lot of people spell it with the E, and they can't find it. MICHAEL_COLYAR. Please follow me on Instagram. My Facebook is my name, Michael Collier. If you want to write me, it's ComicKing123. ComicKing123 at AOL.com, and I have a very sexy webpage called TheRealMichaelCollier.com where you can find out all this information, every place I'm going, my 100 city tour called Michael Collier's Mama, my new movie called Showboat's House Party, and my new TV show called, I can't even tell y'all, it's so awesome, bro. It's so awesome.
So many good
but
you'll
be, oh, I'm so blessed. I'm so thrilled. I thank God every day, day and night. I live with an attitude of gratitude. Everything I have is a gift and a blessing. I don't have anything because I'm better than nobody. Because I ain't better than nobody, but ain't no motherfucker better than me. I'm just Michael Collier trying to do my best, man, try not to hurt nobody along the way.
Amen.
Yeah.
This has been awesome.
This has been a real pressure. Yeah. I mean, pleasure.
Whatever. I'll take it.
Thank you. I appreciate
you. Thank you so much.
God bless you. And I'm honored that you let me be part of it.
Oh, yes. Yeah. Thank you, you guys. Season 2 is kicking. It's so many awesome comedians coming.
Chicken. The chicken always gives me. That chicken is very popular. And just let me see the cover of my new show, Michael Collier's Mama. If you like your mama, you're going to love this show.
Oh, right.
Thank you.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you. Thank you, dear heart.